Hey team, Andre from High Performance Academy. Welcome along to another one of our webinars. We just wanted to show you a technology that we see on quite a few factory engines where the inlet manifold is designed with a set of flaps or variable inlet runners so that they can optimize the torque curve across a wider power band. And essentially the premise here is that a longer intake runner favors bottom RPM or low RPM performance, improved low RPM torque. But if we want optimum performance at high RPM, generally we need a shorter inlet runner, and it's often difficult, understandably, to get both in one package. So across on my laptop screen, this is the inlet manifold design on the Toyota 3U ZFE 4.3 litre V8 that we've got going into our Toyota FJ40 project. And this actually incorporates a set of butterflies and dual runners for each inlet port inside of this manifold. And we've just had it apart, and I thought it'd be a good idea to snap some shots to show you how that all works. Not like that, much like this. So this is the upper manifold here, so we can see the ports, and we've got this set of butterflies here in the middle of the manifold. So these are actuated by a little vacuum solenoid. And if we scroll over, this is the lower part of the manifold. So this all bolts together. Basically, it's got a fairly long convoluted inlet path when the long runner is activated, much shorter with the butterflies in the higher RPM position. And that's all actuated by this little vacuum solenoid vacuum actuator that sits on the back of that manifold. You can see there's a little arm here, and that actually directly actuates those butterflies that we saw in that last shot. And how this is all functioned is via this little vacuum accumulator here. So this just builds or holds vacuum from the inlet manifold, and then we've got a little solenoid under here that basically provides that vacuum through to the actuator here, kind of a bit like a turbo wastegate, and it opens. So it's quite effective. And one of the tricks is, if you don't know that this system works, you're going to end up, depending on whether the system is naturally open or naturally closed, you're either going to end up giving away a fair chunk of bottom end performance or a fair chunk of high RPM performance. So definitely worth incorporating if you've got the ability. And I just want to also show you some of the aspects of the tuning of this. So we'll just jump into a file I did for a 3U ZFE quite a while ago, and unfortunately I didn't really have the functionality I needed here to operate this the way I wanted, back with a very old firmware package from MoTeC. This was done probably about 5 years ago now. And if we look at our VE table over here on the right hand side, you can actually see pretty much where this is switching in, and you can see that based on this step here. So if I scroll across, we are switching there at 3500 RPM. Now, there's a problem here though. If we are switching based purely on RPM, what we'll generally find, and this goes for the likes of VTEC mechanisms as well, is that ideally we really want to shift it based on based on a window that involves both engine RPM as well as manifold pressure or throttle position. What I'm basically saying is that the ideal RPM to switch that system at wide open throttle, 100 kPa, is almost certainly going to be different to what we'd like to shift it at maybe 20 or 30% throttle. And that shows up here because we didn't have that ability, so we're just switching it at 3500 RPM. And we can see that at wide open throttle, which is where we're up basically right at the top of this VE table at 100 kPa, we can see that there's essentially no real big jump or step across that switchover point. However, when we drop back down here at lower manifold pressure, we can see quite a noticeable step. And to me, looking at this, that straight away is a bit of an indication that there's potentially some benefit in switching that point based on both RPM and our manifold pressure. Again, I couldn't do that. Another point to note here is with a system like this goes for VTEC as well, we really want to include a little bit of hysteresis around the switchover point. And what I mean by this is we want to, let's say, switch on at 3500 RPM, but once it's switched on, we might have a 25 or a 50 RPM hysteresis, which means that the RPM would need to drop back down to 3450 RPM before it switches off. It might sound like a subtle and irrelevant difference, but what it does is it stops the solenoid switch or the system switching on and off rapidly if we just happen to be at that exact RPM. And it might sound unlikely, but I can guarantee you it happens much more than you would expect. Now, other point, last point I'll make on this as well is while if we could have done this based on RPM and throttle position or manifold pressure, we wouldn't have this big step that I've been talking about. In this case, we do. So what we want to do is have quite tight spacing in our breakpoints. So you can see I've done that. I've got one at 3500 RPM, which is the switch on point, and then I've got one directly after this at 3550 RPM. Now what that does is it sort of accentuates this step, but we do see quite a significant change in volumetric efficiency in this lower load area. So that allows me to make sure that I've got the fueling correct at low load where we've got that step. So just a couple of pointers there.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.